Good morning, everyone. We're continuing here in the words of the Orchis Yosher in the trait of humility. And the Gemara and Rav Chaim Kanievsky writes the following words. It says, "Ve'ein ha'Torah miskayemes ela ba'anovim." The Torah is only going to be absorbed by people that are humble. K'mo she'amru, like it says, "Ha'Torah niknes ba'anova." The Torah is acquired with humility, and it's a clear and simple understanding. The Torah itself is the Das Elokis, it's the word of Hashem. HaKadosh Baruch Hu's word is Emes, is truth, it's His Rasan, it's His will, it's the way in which He runs and guides and keeps the universe and mankind and Klal Yisrael being as we are. The Torah is way beyond a person because it's coming from Hashem. The only way that a person's truly going to be able to learn the Torah is if they humble themselves to realize that I simply do not know everything, I don't understand everything. Whatever little bit of Torah that I have learned, there's so much more that I could learn. Even if I learned everything, I could go so much deeper. HaKadosh Baruch Hu's knowledge is vast and infinite, and I'm a finite being. When I come in with that approach, with anivus, with humility, then I'll be able to observe the Torah. However, absorb the Torah. If I'm a person who's filled with myself, with haughtiness, with gaiva, so on and so forth, so then the Torah will not be able to rest upon me. Like it says, va'omru kol ha'misyahir, anyone who is pretentious, who is haughty, im chachamu, if he's a wise person, he has a lot of Torah knowledge, chachmosa mistaleches mimenu, his Torah is going to fly away from him, it's going to leave him. V'im Navihu, if he is a prophet, nevuasa mistalekes mimeno, then his prophecy is going to leave him as well. V'amru, and like it says, divrei Torah, the words of Torah, e miskaimin, they're not going to last by a person, to stay by a person, ela b'mi shedaita ishfala alav, except for the person who is unassuming, who is lowers himself, who is humble in his ways. That's how the Torah is going to exist for such a person. However, if he becomes someone that is too haughty and too proud of himself, it will be impossible for the Torah to last. There's a really beautiful story of Rav Chaim Kanievsky. He himself, the tremendous humility that he has in so many areas of his life, even though that it probably in modern day and age, there's never been a single gadol, a single giant of Klal Yisrael that has had more publicity and PR and more pictures and more videos that are flying around the world than he has. And everybody knows that his house is open day and night for people that are coming for their blessings. They have questions, they have things, difficult things that they're going through. And nevertheless, he is someone that is known tremendously for his humility that he has. So there's a beautiful story. It's very common that people come to Rav Chaim Kanievsky with their halachic questions. And some of the Torah scholars come over the years with many, many questions, and they keep track of all of the answers that Rav Chaim gives. So one of these people once sent a letter to Rav Chaim Kanievsky asking for an answer. And Rav Chaim wrote back his answer, what he felt was the psak, was the halachic decision. The man wrote back, the Torah scholar wrote back to Rav Chaim Kanievsky that he believes that Rav Chaim made a mistake and that the answer really should be something else. Rav Chaim looked at his answer and he said, Taka, you're right. And he wrote back to this scholar over here that I made a mistake. And here is the correct answer. So now this man came to Rav Chaim Kanievsky sometime later and he said, I've been collecting and saving all of our correspondence over the years. I'd like to publish a sefer, a book, with all of my questions and all of your answers. And I'd like to know if I can put in the correspondence where you sent me an answer. I sent you back that it was wrong and you sent back that you made a mistake. Can I put that in there as well? So Rav Chaim said over initially, you know what, better you don't have to. I made a mistake. What's the reason of putting it in print? They should only see when the psak, the halachic decision that I issue is correct. And then he said, I changed my mind. And I told the person, you know what, you can print that correspondence in there as well. On the contrary, he said, let people see that I made a mistake. And once they know that I make mistakes, they'll know that they shouldn't rely upon me when it comes to practical halacha. This is the humility that Chazal are referring to over here, that when a person is humble, they will be imbued with the Torah, and they will hold on to their wisdom, and not chalila, that their wisdom will leave them. Have a wonderful day.